The cauliflower. I'm really stumped. I see no evidence of head starting. And I don't know what to make of it. I've never had this happen before. I don't know why it's happening now. But it's just kind of there. And it's not doing a darn thing. So I'm going to give it more time because I still think it's early considering when I got them in, but frustrating. One thing I want to just, I'm going to use an example here, with this lasagna garden, one thing that's really nice is when you want to pull a weed, because the layers are so nice and loose, the weeds can't get a good foothold. I see one right here, and it takes like just nothing to pull a weed out, and you get the roots and all. So it's really easy weeding in this layered system. So let's just carry on. Thank you, Lena.
You're welcome.
And over here are the cantaloupes, and we're getting little cantaloupe coming. There's my finger for reference. Someone told me, and I did not know this, that cucumbers and melons and squashes will cross-pollinate so that you get nasty fruit. I didn't know that, so I'm a little concerned. I've had squashes in the garden before, I've had cantaloupe in the garden before, but they've always been a separate square. I used to have 9 4x4 foot raised beds in my square foot garden, and so they each had a square to themselves. They weren't side by side like in this situation. And I was not aware that could happen. So I'll either get really nice sweet squashes and nasty melons, or hopefully maybe that won't happen. I don't know. I'll keep you posted. Well, there's a nice big little muskmelon coming. Okay. This is my sugar baby watermelon. And of course that got started from seed, so that's a little behind. And then of course this Amazon plant here, the acorn squash. It's over the trellis and looking for some place to go. I think it's eyeing the fir tree branches. I'm kind of afraid of it. Oh, don't go too close, Lena. what an amazing plant. There's three of them, as I've said before, and I just can't get over it. And it's setting fruit. I'm going to go on the other side to show you. I picked all my broccoli, the main heads, and now I'm just getting the little side heads right now. In fact, I went through today and picked it all. And with this many plants, about every other day, I can get enough to have for supper or dehydrate or whatever. Like, here's one right here.
Yeah.
Oh, you want it? There. It's harvested, Lena.
Okay.
There's another little one. You're so silly. Don't be goofy.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Mom.
I'm not filming you being goofy. Come here. Here's a couple more.
Hi.
Some of the little ones. You know who else would like that? Would be a guinea pig.
Huh?
Yeah, she'd like that. It's got good vitamin C in it for her.
Oh, good.
Okay, let's go back here and just look at the acorn squashes. And again, I'll tie them up if I have to. But for reference, there's my hand. Yeah, that one's even bigger. Up here.
And
so you can see these vines they're coming down on this side looking for purchase. And they're coming off on the side here as well.
Yeah.
Way over here.
Thank you.
There's
their leaves are so big.
Lena. See? Weeds come right out. That wasn't a weed. That was a spinach. Got to see it. Oh well. And the raspberries are doing very well. In fact, I'm going to take this in to my husband. We're going to have to get out here and weed a little bit, but bless its heart, one of them decided to make fruit for us this year. In fact, well, actually two of them. This one's just behind. But we're going to take that nice big fat raspberry and let Daddy have it, aren't we?
Yeah. Maybe for the middle of the pancake.
I'm going to weed around those. And the strawberries filled in very nicely this year, so hopefully we'll get a good crop. There's that volunteer tomato plant, and I'm pretty sure, I'm almost 100% sure, that it's going to be a yellow pear. I'm letting it go. It's not in the middle, so no big deal. So that's a garden update. I'm behind. I've played this week. I'm going to post some videos of what we did, And I really should have been out here planting this bare spot with a second planting of something. But I played this week instead. We just have had gorgeous weather, and I couldn't resist. We went to the fair and another thing. I know, I filmed that one, sweetheart. It's a muskmelon.
Ooh,
or it might be a frankenmelon if it cross-pollinated. We'll find out.
It's a frankenmelon.
We'll find out. Well, it's, you know, gardening, it's a learning experience, and I learn something new every day.
Step by step.
Yes, Lena. So that's just a little garden update, and I hope things are going well at your house, and your summer is going well, too. Till next time, YouTube. Bye-bye.
Can we open it?